black people in that. How come we're the only ones being told how to live our lives? Why is that? I'm getting tired of that too. Mr. Harper doesn't have to wake me up in the morning to go to work. I can do that by myself. We can educate our kids. We wake them up, send them to school. Harper doesn't have to do that for us. We run our own education system. We run our own health system in our communities, our social services, our economic development. Why in the world can we not have our own child welfare to keep our own? People always tell us, you should take care of your own. Well, my God, give us that. And let us take it up. The money that the CAS, Children's Society, get, move that over to us. We'll run our own. And believe me, we will get along a lot better. Our kids will be happier. We pay our fair share. Your university here, your college, my son's graduating from St. Mary. I love it. But we pay the tuitions too. Our communities, us, we paid it. My own, I just got out of debt, still owe a little bit. That's almost 15 years ago. I paid my kids, we paid our share. You add that up with all our kids. We paid the tuitions here. But at the same time, because of HST, there's a lot of information being shared with us. We're open for business. I wish we could open a big school. That would impact them, a lot of cities where they hate us. You take away $20 million from Algoma or Sioux College, that would have a big impact. But we'll be striving in our communities. So again, I am very vocal that everything that we're talking about here, at the end of the day, is this taxation thing. We paid our share. And our veterans were the first ones that made the payments with their lives, laying down their lives. I can say that over and over again, just so we don't forget. We are forgetting the veterans right across this country. There's not very many anymore. You probably can count them in your hands how much in your municipality is left, if any. We are forgetting them. I go at home now. My God, there's only about 100 of us that gather, where it used to be almost 1,000. So people just don't have time to say, me great, thank you anymore to these people. You always hear us say, and it's a truth, it's a reality for me, for all of us, we're not going nowhere. I was just taking this off, I think I'm on the plus side yet, but I'm on my 8th or 9th prime minister. I'm still here. I think I'm on my 15th minister of Indian Affairs. I'm still here. We're not going nowhere. And should I ever lose, when I lose, I will someday, my leader, my chief will, but I will always be there right till the day I die. I will speak for our kids. And again, a little bit more on that residential school, the fallout of it today. 2 summers ago, I was in Thunder Bay at the Friendship Center. This man comes up to me, tapping on my shoulder, and says, you don't remember me, recognize me, eh? I looked at him, should I? And then he said, you don't, eh? I said, well, should I? When did I meet you? He said, I seen you 41 years ago. Oh, Jesus. One of us looked different, I guess. But you know who he was when he told me his name? The very man that slapped me around to try this because I spoke my language in school. He's teaching our Ojibwe language now. There's something wrong with that picture. I was born with my language, and no other nationality of people can teach me my language, or they can't teach our language. And for him to be standing over there when he's trying to knock it out of me, and he's teaching it now and the government's paying him, come on, let's turn the page. You want to turn the page, let's turn the page then. Let's respect each other in that front. The language in this country, number one, is our language. Chief Sitting Bull. I have his picture at home. And he's got a little message on the bottom. Once all the resources are gone, underground, all the animals are gone, and last but not least, once the water is gone. Look at the Gulf. Right now as we sit here, look, who's ruling the water? When that is gone, he says, the government can chew on the money and then see how long they live without water. So true. When everything is gone, there's only money left. There's only one way to go. That was a big, when I read that, and I have his picture, so true. So, again to all of us here, we share all this frustration, but the movement's there for our leadership are getting stronger. Our kids want to be leaders now. Your kids want to be leaders too. So we gotta stay with this. We have a friendship treaty where I come from, I'm not doing it to municipalities. Sure, we got our ups and downs, but it works. Nobody wants to see any closure anymore. The government asked my former Grand Council Chief John Lucas to don't close the roads or the railways. We'll work with you. What does our Grand Chief do? He asked our communities, okay, let's back off. The government said they'll work with us. Well, when the HST first come about, again our Grand Chief asked, well, what's going on? To the government, what's going on with this HST? We don't want it. And the government says, why? Your people are not doing anything. Your people are quiet. Oh my God, you asked us to be quiet. You said you would work with us. So we're right back to where we are now. But yes, as Darrell mentioned here, there was a call was made yesterday by the man, one man, who's holding up progress on HST talks for Ontario. One man, he made that call yesterday. And I hope it's not a solid one. I hope it's a positive one that's going to happen in the next few days here. Our youth are coming up. There was a road closure. Only matter a few minutes, but it was road closure in Espanola a few weeks ago. An 18-year-old girl, a 15-year-old girl from Pemacon, led them group of youths to that highway. We had no say in that. Our youth are moving past us. They want to see action. There was another one after that, a week after in Toronto, in regards to children in society. There was another big youth gathering at Queen's Park, led by that same girl. And believe me, when our kids stand to fight for what they believe in, I'm with them all the way. Middle of the highway or middle of the lawn of Queen's Park, I don't care where it is. So, ladies and gentlemen, we just ask, again, that we keep our communities, our province, tax-free from the HST. That will go up if this implemented. Look at Nova Scotia. Government of the day, no taxes on HST will be increased. They publicly renamed, and it went up 2%. And it will still keep going up. That's what will happen here, too. So with that, again, Jimmy Goetz.